You got to run us through what you can even remember about that moment. Because I realize when you're calling games, you probably, there's a lot of stuff that just kind of goes in and out. You don't remember. What do you remember leading up to that? Do you remember the goal? Do you remember saying Benino, Benino? Do you remember the anything afterwards?
So I get into it very detailed in the book.
Okay,
there's
so we won't
actually
ruin it.
There's actually several Benino calls. I'll give you a little bit of a so the first one that ever happened was a mistake in my notes, and I'll give this away. Where for left wing, center, and right wing, I accidentally wrote Benino's name down for all three positions. And that is the mistake that became the blessing in disguise. So that was in my head, and the adrenaline's pumping, and he scored some big goals on this HBK line for the Penguins with Carl Hagelin and Phil Kessel. They were basically the engine that drove the team in those playoffs. And so the adrenaline's pumping, and he scores the first one was against Washington, actually. And so that's what came out of my, and we have an enthusiastic style. I know for the Leafs fans watching this, I'm sure some of you have heard the Mitch Marner. I like when he scores a game winning goal or an overtime winner and that type of thing. We like to have quite a bit of fun with it. And it's enthusiastic to say the least. And so when Benino scored that goal, what was in my mind was Benino, 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 but it was, came out times 10 or 11. And initially we Pittsburgh Penguins fans in the area of Pennsylvania, like we got a lot of love from them. And little did we know though, like they were demanding, they were like, we want another Benino call, another Benino call. And then, we reached the Stanley Cup final. It's game one. And it was just served on a platter. Like there was such a demand for it. And it's 2.5 minutes to go. I remember the goal. He's standing just right in front of the net and he just gets it. He just shovels it. And there you go against the Sharks. And it was just there. And then my voice even cracked while it was people love that for some reason, it's embarrassing for me, but people have mentioned that to me so much. And then of course, after that, they win the Stanley Cup, the team invites us to the parade. And then everything that happened from there with meeting Lemieux and talking, surprising the team in the dressing room, there is so much, that's such a fun memory in our career wise. I consider Nick Benino a good friend now, and he's such a great guy. And there's some really cool moments mentioned in the book about that whole thing, about how we were rock stars in Pittsburgh for a couple of years there.
It was a fascinating social media moment for me personally, because I was at that game. So,
oh, wow.
Yeah, so I wasn't able to, watch the broadcast because I was there.
Yeah.
And I noticed, as we're walking sort of around the courtyard, people are, they're starting to, check this out, and they're showing everyone. And sure enough, I saw it within a few minutes. You were an instant sensation with everyone in Pittsburgh. It was fascinating to watch.
Yeah, we had a cult following there. People were telling me that you have no idea how big this is in Pittsburgh. And when we got to Pittsburgh, even on the flight to Pittsburgh, people are taking pictures and tweeting it out. And it was just, wow. It was crazy. People were stopping cars along the streets when they saw us walking to jump out and get pictures with us. Benino, Nick himself was saying that so many, obviously his teammates were into it big time, but he said for, years after that, opposing players on the ice were always saying it to him. He had so many people who had it as their ringtone, and it was just, him and I'll have this special bond for the rest of our careers. And even for the show, for Hockey Night Punjabi, my colleagues and I, that, as you mentioned in your question first, it was revolutionary for our show, for ourselves personally, career-wise, to be able to put ourselves on the map. So it was just, like I say, a mistake that was a blessing in disguise.
You guys have done some, I don't know if it's funny or interesting, translations to hockey terms. Like you have a different term for like penalty box or when there's a bad period. Can you explain some of those?
Yeah. And the, one of the cool things in the book is I put a bit of a glossary in there as a guide to watching Hockey Night Punjabi. And the penalty box one is kind of my favorite in the sense that it adds some dramatic flair and it adds the spice. You've probably had some Punjabi East Indian food and it's always got the nice spicy flavor to it. So penalty box, we say saja da dabba, which means back in English as box of punishment, right? So it's everything's kind of a much more fun way of doing things. Like if a team has a bad period, the amount of chai we drink in our culture is just, I've got it here. I can't even do one of these interviews without it. If a team has a bad period, it's like, even with the chai, it's like, so during the intermission, they need to go get some chai, a cup of chai, man. They need to figure it out so that they're better. Like that was a horrible period. Right. So there's so many kind of those, terms that we've created that are hybrids, or then you have fun with it. And we really like, you know, sports is, it's for entertainment. You guys know this in terms of how much fun you guys have. But you know, that should be at the forefront too. Like it should be business when it's, you know, a serious part of the game, or it's, you know, a certain point in the playoffs. But for the most part, you want to make sure you're having fun and that the audience is having fun. And that's really what our show has been about.
I wish that kind of energy was on the English broadcast. I'll be honest, on any network at any time. I love the energy that you guys have, and I think it's missing, frankly, from a lot of the broadcasts that are happening. I think hockey's a little too slow on the broadcast end, and I've been on the record of that. And I know that can land me some hot water with our colleagues.
Except works for Bell.
Oh no! Yeah,
I'll say it about TSN. I'll say it about Sportsnet. I think that they fire it up. Somebody get them some chai. So, yeah.